Hey yo everyone, this is the Happy Anime Cafe Manager here with another blind walkthrough episode for the game Xenoblade Chronicles 3D. Fiora has met up with Shulk and Ryan. Together they set out for the Magmel ruins deep inside Tepra Cave. Someone with a quest.
Yes?
Going into the cave, can you kill a willow bunny for me? They attack in packs, so could be quite a nuisance. Help the defense soldier by defeating monsters in the threatening of the monster threatening the safety of Tepra Cave. Defeat one the willow bunny. A lot of backlot lighting from the kitchen. Quest number 4, defeat Bunnif. Tepra Cave. There are many types of monsters. The type of monster shown in the large window, in the target window, in the options, you can set the type of to always be displayed. Ordinary monsters will not attack you unless you attack them. Normal type icons. Visual types will attack when they see your character. Corner of the world. It's a little disorienting in this cave. Cave rat. Alright, quest done.
Fabulous. Everyone, let's go.
Achievement, turning it around. Jaws got the achievement, Jaws of Defeat. Ugh, man. Characters are pretty beat up right now. I mean, yeah, they are recovering gradually. But I think I've taken on more than I could chew. Prom Skeeter. Ooh. Eater caterpillar. Be aware of unique monsters. Unique monsters are much stronger than the other monsters in the field. Defeat a unique monster and you will be rewarded with better quality items. Yeah, we're not ready for them yet. Location caterpillar nest. Yeah, don't bother with those guys. I'm too underleveled. I did try being a unique monster. It's on level 5, but even when I equip on level 7, when I have Shulk on level 7 equipped with better armor and everything. The defense of that this one particular caterpillar or unique monster is just too strong. And besides, Shulk is just taking him on by himself. Game over already. Yeah, first game over in this project. If the leader is incapacitated, you will return to the previous landmark. When the leader's HP reaches 0, the leader falls from too great a height, the party will become incapacitated. You will be returned to the last landmark visited. Falling off a cliff or 0 HP. Keep an eye out on the party gauge. Incapacitated battle resumes. Incapacitated back to landmark. If the leader becomes incapacitated in battle, but there is at least one block left in the party gauge, the battle will continue and you will not be returned to the last landmark you visited. I'm trying to revive them. The importance of levels and equipment. If you're not able to win a battle, check the level difference between your party and the enemy. Also remember to equip your party with strong weapons and armor too. Yeah, I really haven't done much so. Yeah, the only way I could get far is if I play my practice file, because in that file, Shulk and Fiora are both on level 11. And I got enough equipment for days. Come on, cheer up. Yeah, that achievement can only be unlocked if you get knocked out at least once.
Fuck. That is so you, Ryan.
Got light shoes, battle armor. Yeah, I lose it. Agility and physical defense. But I think Ryan will benefit from this. Boots, light shoes for Shulk.
Nice job, man, what a bunch of jokers.
There's the treasure chest from before. Shin Gecko. Swimming oil. Ooh, I get an agility boost with swimming oil, but he doesn't have his shirt on. Ah. Put the colony top back on. What does Fiora look like with swimming oil? Well, she could use the defense anyway. Ugh, Ryan takes a while to fully recover. Well, he does have a huge amount of HP. Magmel Ruins.
Are these the Magmel Ruins?
Haven't you been here before?
Nope.
The Defense Force often uses it for training, but I come here to do research. It's not really a place that people go.
Not surprising. There are monsters around here that use Mekon parts as armor.
Was this built by the Mekon?
I don't think so. There's a path for people to get in. It might have been a vehicle of some kind. Like the Defense Force hover transports.
A vehicle? But it's so big.
It's amazing technology. I wonder what kind of people made it. I ain't got a clue. Let's keep moving. The ether cylinders are up ahead. Right.
Take shortcuts using skip travel. Use skip travel to return to landmarks you have previously visited. Open the map of the area you wish to travel to. You can return to the shop in the colony. View the map and select the landmark you wish to travel to. It's probably a good idea to return to the colony when your inventory is full so that you can sell some items that at the shop for money. Okay, Waterhouse 2. Rumble Stonefly. Iron Bunnet. Critical Thinking. Topple. Wet hair. Night tulip. Dark grape. Didn't mean it. You really need to pick a fight with this guy. Got light gloves. The Magmel ruins appear to actually be an ancient vehicle. The ether cylinder is in the ship hangar. The group must be ahead for the cylinder hangar at the back of the ruins. I'm a little nervous on what's ahead. Gold caterpillar. It won't open now. Mount lizard.
Backslash!
net level 9 Mel Lizard. Oh man, everyone got knocked down. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. Until next time, to be continued, baby.